So versus the normal Z06 that you had, this is a massive jump, right? Because now this has got, what, 750 horsepower?
757.
757. And then with that being said,
it's but not going to heat soak. and that's that has to do with everything that's been done by the gentleman.
Yeah, Pete right here. How's it going, Pete?
Hey, Austin, how are you?
Meet Pete Callaway, son of Mr. Callaway, right? Uh-huh. Yeah, I stopped by the shop with them recently to check out this car being built, and again, it is just so unreal. Do you mind if you go over a few of the things real quick that's like the major changes with this model being the 25th anniversary, right?
Yeah, let me pop the hood.
You got the shaker hood, shaker engine cover right there.
Yeah, actually that's a cool point because you know, the heart of this is the 757 package, and that is replacing the factory 1740cc supercharger with our 2300. It's still the Eaton unit, but we've packaged three intercooler bricks in this housing, so instead of just a cover, this is actually the supercharger that we're looking at.
Is that carbon right there?
Yeah, carbon fiber.
Pretty warm.
That's mostly a cosmetic detail cover, hides the coils and such.
I gotcha.
So with the triple cooled intercooler system, we call it, we really have very good control of intake air temperature.
Yeah.
The other side of this car is it has our optional HD cooling package, which is the new grill you see.
Yeah, that's the main thing that you notice looking at it, is that the whole front end's been redone, right?
Right.
And I love the carbon fiber with it, and it looks really mean, Tom. It looks mean.
So the secret to fixing the Z06's cooling challenge is that basically, we've taken the supercharger's low-temp radiators out of the main duct, and we've split them into two side coolers that you can see in the side ducts here. So they're their own dedicated airflow, and they work very well. It's a super high-efficiency core made by PWR. If you can do a half-an-hour session, you can watch all the data and see when the car's cooling systems actually saturate and stabilize, then you know you've achieved something. So in this case, freeing up the center airflow for the car's original radiator, which actually works fine if given good airflow. The other thing we do is we take the oil cooler heat load out of the water circuit. In the factory car, it's a water to oil heat exchanger for the oil cooler.
Okay.
Which when the water temperature is not controlled, it's not doing much for cooling the oil anymore. So
I gotcha.
In this lower slot, there's actually a new splitter as well. And in here you can see there's sort of a mail slot opening with an air to oil cooler added, which is outside of the rest of the cooling stack.
So in general then, you guys upgraded the cooling, the engine power with the right. It looks like you have new brakes as well. And then you have increased aero, right? More downforce, especially in the rear.
Right, so there's a few competition options in this car, one of which is the GT3 wing and lower spoiler. So you can see it's a low drag spoiler, but it's got a nice rearward extension over the car. That's also from our GT3 car, basically bolt on. The wing is, with the exception that it's about 100 millimeters more narrow
than
the stock body. And this balances quite well with the cooling system and the new splitter and under tray in the front, which helps decrease lift in the front. So the aero improvement is really well balanced. Developed at Callaway Competition, our shop in Germany. Hockenheim is our home track there. So this car really does work, and put a good seat in the car, harnesses.
You know what, man? Ton of fun to drive. One thing's for certain, though.